Hello everybody, this is Quinzell, and since this is the year 2025, I feel like the very best gift that Sims lover can give themselves is the gift of Sims 2. It is now considered abandonware. It's actually pretty easy to install. I found out how to do it through a cotton sock about 3 years ago, so I'm going to go through it again just to see if anything's changed and guide you through it. Okay, so I clicked on the link from a cotton sock, and as you can see, there's a highlighted text for a brand new link, an easier way to download. It didn't look like this before, but this is what I'm going to click to move forward. And they have a new setup model than what I had, and they have some information down here. Now let's see, they want us to scroll down to the aspects of the bottom release, or the latest release, and download the starter pack. Check step 2, 3, 4. And they have a graphic rule maker message right here, which they didn't have before, so that's a nice additive. So I guess this new process also installs that as well, so you don't have to do it separately, which it helps out a lot. Like, your game will look a lot rougher without the graphics rules going into effect. Okay, so this is version 15.0.3. Last updated in October of last year. Let you know that this is still very much a handled product, and there's always fine tune it and adding new things to this installer to make it easier on newcomers. So let me head back. I have the program loaded, so I am about to start. Of course, you're gonna, well, normally with Windows, you get this little pop-up right here. We're gonna have to click the Run It Anyway option to get it started. Now this is where I'm just gonna match up and see which part of these options apply to me. You're gonna have to check your own settings and, you know what kind of cards you have, what kind of video card you have. Mine is not that advanced on this desktop. On my laptop, yes, but since I have a simple integrated card, I'm just gonna stick with the basics. Though I do see also that one of the additives that they have is the extra clean hood template, which is something that wasn't offered when I installed it, like, I don't know, 3 years ago or whatever. But I'm glad that they're adding new things, just like they added the graphic rules maker installation as well. I know that installing it can feel a bit intimidating, but once you get past this point, basically it starts installing itself like it did to me. I am at the finishing line, actually. I had to come back a few minutes later because I didn't want to bore you with having you wait. Of course, the wait time will depend on your computer, and mine isn't the fastest thing around, but it should be good enough for Sims. Now, they installed two fixes already to my game. Well, one's a fix and one of them's, I'm not quite sure what the enabled one does, but if they think I need it, then I need it. It's going to finish up installing, and then it's going to offer me the graphics rule maker, which, again, I said it was a new thing. All we got to do is find Sims 2 and do the auto detect and save, and then we're going to do the same for Body Shop. Because I don't know if you know, I like playing in Body Shop, and I've been getting into recolors. It is very, very fun to me. And I've been working on custom skins, and I want to see the product as best as possible. And obviously we need to update the graphics a bit for that. So just auto detect, save, and you're done with that part. Now in my desktop computer, I had to manually do some changes where graphics rule makers didn't quite get it together like I needed it to get it together. It did most of it, but there were still some things I had to do manually, and that was a little bit more scarier with having to go to the file and open it up and things like that. But there are plenty of tutorials online to help you with that if you have to go the manual route. This is just telling you about the different graphics cards you may have. On my laptop, I had to add my graphics card manually. But that's because mine's is a little bit better setup than, say, my desktop. This time I didn't have to do it, but if you did, they have the steps here for you to follow. Just take it slow and take your time, and, you know, set aside some time when you're not, like, you know, hungry or in a rush or anything like that. Because setting it up right, you know, it takes a little bit longer. If you do it once, you'll be happier. If you rush it, you'll have to come back and try to figure out what you did wrong. And I hope that's not the case for you. Now, I wasn't quite sure if I needed a DVX, but it turns out after rereading this again, I realized that I actually didn't. So I am going to move on to the next step while it keeps downloading. And as you can see, I'm pretty close, though again, it did take me a few minutes to get to this part. Now they do have a section just for the DXVK confirmation setup. It is also something that a cotton sock goes over with you as well. And if I'm not mistaken, she also goes over a manual way to set it up if this one doesn't work. But that video is, I think, 3 years old, and I'm pretty sure since they updated this not too long ago, you don't have to follow through that particular thing. Now, as you saw, the RPC launcher has popped up, and it's from Lazy Duchess, who makes some of the most amazing, incredible mods for Sims 2 and for 3 that are unbelievable. She even did a story progression mod, which all of us would say was not even possible. So here's the RPC launcher, and it's telling you in the setup guide what they would recommend and what they wouldn't recommend and how you should start the game. I pretty much remember how I want it, and I don't want to put too much of a strain on my desktop PC, because it's not as advanced as, say, my laptop. So I'm not going to shoot for the sky, so to speak. I will end up changing the design tool cost to zero, because I hate paying $15 every time I want to change a swatch, because I do it a little bit too often. And I'm going to make it work for me. I encourage you to decide which works for you as well, and just know your computer. If you don't think it can handle too much, just start off lightly and see how you like it, and then, you know, gradually increase things here or there to set up your game. For the sake of demonstration, I'm just gonna shoot my design tool cost down to $10, and I am going to save and play so you can see what it looks like. Okay, so every time you start a brand new or install The Sims 2 for the first time, you'll get this pop-up concerning all the downloadable CC content you have. And you can just turn this off in the game settings after you enter a neighborhood. I'm just gonna go into Desiderata because it's right there in my face. Okay, so I'm going to test the limits a little bit. I updated my things to medium just a bit, and I'm gonna apply the changes because I like my Sims look pretty and no matter what game I'm playing. So that's what I'm going to do. And next we're gonna see about changing the see that button right there, display custom contact dialogue at startup. I am gonna make sure that's off so you don't have to see that notice again. Okay, so I just loaded up this family that I've never played with in my life, and probably, actually, I don't think I played in this whole hood in my life, but I just want you to see how it looks after you have everything installed, if everything goes according to plan. One of the fixes that they installed was the shadow fixes. Without that, last time I installed it, it was like they had a black square shape border right around them, like they were about to be sucked into a black hole. And I don't know when and why that happened, but Sim Nokey had made a fix for it. But thanks to this new upgrade to this installation, they already got it automatically installed so that new time players won't have to go through what I went through. And that's pretty much it. That's all I needed to start playing Strangerville once again. And playing Pleasantville. Actually, I'm playing early Pleasantville because I just wanted to see, Pleasantview, because I just wanted to see what it looked like starting it at the beginning. And of course, they're creating dramas, and Strangetown is just one of my favorites. I love to populate it with so many alien Sims, and I got this beautiful custom alien mod, PT4 mod. And I've just been watching them grow up and have kids and improving and loving the genetics. But also, you can start your very own projects. There's all kinds of challenges, build a silly challenges, medieval challenges, things like that. In fact, that's what's got me into the game at actually start playing. And I just want to thank all of the other creators who gave me inspiration and let you know that it's not over. You can make your own stories, you can have fun again, you can create drama, and you can enjoy the game that you have loved for years once again. There's nothing stopping you. The only mountain in your way is you. So get on it, get it installed, and have fun. And I look forward to seeing what you post.